For those of you who have enjoyed our Shape Cut Ruler, now you can get all the same cutting techniques of the Shape Cut, only with the Shape Cut Plus Ruler. It's now 6 inches longer, so you get a full 18 inches of cutting. Additionally, our new big Shape Cut Plus Ruler has a 1/4 inch dotted line, so you can cut in 1/4 inch or 1/2 inch increments. Cut all your quilting shapes quickly and accurately. Strip squares, triangles, diamonds, bias, and even fringe in either 1/2 or 1/4 inch increments. Let's show you how this works. For cutting basic strips, squares, triangles, and diamonds, click on our Shape Cut video. It will show you how to cut all those shapes in full 1/2 inch and inch increments. To cut in 1/4 inches, however, on this long ruler, I'd like to show you that we include our packaging insert with the ruler, and on the back of the packaging insert, we show you how to cut strips of all those trickier 1/4 inch cuts. Everything from 3/4 inch strips all the way up to 4 1/4 inch strips. Today I'm going to show you how to cut 1 3/4 inch strips, so I'm going to be using this part of the packaging instructions right here. Hang on to these, they're going to come in handy for you down the road as you have quilts that require all these different types of cuts. So to cut our 1 3/4 inch strips, I'm going to square up the edge of my fabric and then I'm going to make all my first cuts as indicated here. So what I'm going to do is start out by putting my ruler on my fabric fold line, that bottom 0 horizontal marking as on the fold of my fabric, and I'm going to square up the edge of my fabric at cutting vertically in the 0 slot. That makes sure I'm starting out with absolutely square fabric. Now I refer to my instructions. It says to make my first cuts at 3 1/2, so I put my blade in at 3 1/2. My second cut it says to make at 7, and then it says to go to 10 1/2. And then it says to go to 14, and then 17 1/2. So I've got my first cuts made. Now see this 1/4 inch mark along here? I'm going to pick up my ruler and I'm going to shift it over so that 1/4 inch mark is now where my original cutting had taken place vertically. And remember, I'm still lined up horizontally across the bottom. Now I'm ready to make my second set of cuts. So I refer back to my instructions. I'm going to cut at 2. I'm going to cut at 5 1/2. There's my 2 cut. And now I'm going to cut at 5 1/2, 9, 12 1/2, and 16. I'm going to take my ruler away and I will have perfect 1 3/4 inch strips. I'm going to take one of these and set it on the mat so that you can see how perfect this is. If I lay it on my mat line, I should have 1/4 inch left over here, and I do. Perfect cuts every time. Now that our perfect 1 3/4 inch strips are cut, if you'd like to turn those into squares, triangles, or diamonds, click on our Shape Cut video and we'll show you the rest of the steps in the process.